Imagine aliens land and give us a clean, limitless energy source. And instead of killing each other over this technology, we decide to immediately transform the world into a carbon-free society. This wondrous source would power our homes, industries, cars, and planes, and humanity's annual rate of carbon pollution would almost instantly fall to zero. So if we kicked our carbon addiction tomorrow, what would that mean for global warming? Hey guys, I'm Joe. So if we stopped burning carbon tomorrow, would the climate suddenly go back to the cooler, calmer atmosphere humans lived under before the Industrial Revolution? Short answer, not exactly. The climate would continue to change and temperatures would remain high for many, many centuries. So that's not great. I know, we've been told for years that slashing greenhouse gas pollution is the key to tackling climate change. And it is. But unfortunately, those cuts wouldn't immediately stop the planet from warming up. One reason is that over the last 50 years, 90% of the extra warming has gone into the oceans. It takes decades for oceans to heat up, but once you quit adding additional heat, they'd still give off the heat that they'd previously accumulated. It's kind of like how a pot of boiling water continues to give off heat long after you've turned off the stove. Because water heats up slowly, it cools off slowly too. And as all this extra heat fully mixes in the deep oceans, the ocean would continue to expand, raising sea levels for centuries. The other reason Earth would stay hot is that CO2 molecules, which cause more than 80% of the warming, remain in the atmosphere for a remarkably long time. If you burn 5 gallons of gas today, you create about 100 pounds of CO2. But way off in the year 3000, as much as 40 pounds of that gas will still be floating in the sky, warming up the planet. Earth has warmed by about 0.8 degrees Celsius since the Industrial Revolution. If we turned off greenhouse gas emissions tomorrow, shorter-lived greenhouse gases like methane and nitrous oxide would be broken down and dissipate first. That would cause the atmosphere to cool by maybe half a degree over about a century. But because CO2 is such a long-lived molecule, it would keep the Earth warmer for at least 2,000 years. So many of the impacts that we're experiencing now, like the melting Arctic, drier droughts, and fiercer thunderstorms, would probably also continue. In the end, CO2 might take as long as 100,000 years to finally return to pre-industrial levels. So even if we cut all emissions tomorrow, the truth is we're guaranteed some amount of climate change and warmer temperatures. But switching to a carbon-free energy system would still give us a lot of benefits immediately. Health is a big one. Over 3 billion people worldwide breathe air that's so polluted that it doesn't meet World Health Organization guidelines. Air pollution from fossil fuels or stoves is thought to cause more than 5 million deaths per year, thanks to things like lung cancer, heart disease, and stroke. The majority of those deaths occur in developing countries where there's more pollution. So halting fossil fuel burning would immediately improve the lives of millions of people. Wild places would also benefit. Some of the world's most pristine environments contain plentiful fossil fuels. Stopping emissions would mean ending fossil fuel extraction, which means less construction in wild areas, less noise pollution, and cleaner air and water. Halting emissions sooner rather than later means that future generations might still face climate impacts, but they'll probably be less severe. For example, with each degree of additional warming that we allow to happen, the amount of area burned by wildfire in the western United States doubles. Each degree of additional warming is also thought to reduce crop yields by as much as 10%. Lowering emissions means fewer fatalities in extreme weather, fewer severe storms, and more children spared the hardship of migration to cooler places. And who knows, maybe one of those kids could grow up to develop some technologies to actually suck the extra carbon straight out of the sky and speed up the cooling. The idea of aliens providing us a magical energy source is, of course, a fantasy. But today, we're already installing real clean energy technologies that could wean us off fossil fuels. Things like solar cells and wind turbines. The decisions that we're making today will affect not only our grandchildren, but their grandchildren's 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 grandchildren. Our addiction to carbon has put us and our descendants into a deep hole. Sometimes it's hard to imagine how we'll climb out. But the best thing we can do for ourselves and for them is to just stop digging. Hey guys, thanks so much for watching. We clearly have no time to waste. If you liked what you watched, consider subscribing. You can click that little bell icon so you get notified whenever we have a new video. You can also check out our Patreon page, where you can help us not only make more videos, but also make them more carbon neutral. Details and links are down in the description.